Hi everyone! Today I'm going to show you a Flask web application which I have connected to PostgreSQL. It is a simple website where students can fill in their data and send it to a PostgreSQL database. To be able to follow this tutorial, you should be familiar with the basics of HTML and Python. Before you can start with the tutorial, you need to install PostgreSQL and PGAdmin 4. I will put the links for this in the description box. PostgreSQL is an object relational database system, and PGAdmin 4 is a graphical user interface for PostgreSQL. A few more modules and libraries we are going to install are Flask, Pip, Env, Psycop G2, and SQL Alchemy. I will show you how you can install these four in a second. Flask is a Python web app framework. Pipenv is used for creating and managing virtual environments, which are needed for the installation of packages. Because in our Python project, when we install packages, we want to have them installed only inside of this project and not globally on our machine. Psycop G2 is a PostgreSQL database adapter, and SQL Alchemy is used for database communication. One task of it, for example, is that it translates classes to tables and converts function calls to SQL statements. My tutorial consists of three parts. First, I'm going to explain my Flask app to you and show how everything is working. Then we are going to create a table for PostgreSQL and gonna post and get some data. And in part three, I'm gonna show you how you can resolve an error that might occur when you set up PostgreSQL and PGAdmin 4. It's about the refusal of a connection with the port 5432, which PostgreSQL wants to use. Let's first have a look at our Flask app with an endpoint for the submit route. The first thing we want to do is to install all the packages we need. So go to your project folder, and to install pipenv, type pip install pipenv. Next, we want to open up the shell of this virtual environment. You can do this by typing pipenv shell. And next, we want to install our other packages. Type pipenv install psycopg2 Flask and Flask SQL Alchemy. Now you can exit this shell environment by typing exit. The starting point of our app is the file app.py. To run the file, click on the green arrow or press the keys Shift and F10. Then here in this window, click on the URL. And then go to your browser where the app started. In my case, it's here. And here we have a basic form where you can input some data and send it to the database. Now I'm going to explain the code in detail. So our starting point is this app.py file. And first we are importing a few modules, like render template, which renders the HTML. Then we also have the module request, which we will use for the posts and get requests. And next in line 4, we create a Flask object, which will be the app then. Line 8 shows the route to the site I showed you, and it will return the index.html file. In line 15, we check if name equals main, and if this is the case, we will run the app. We are setting debug to true, which means that the app will be reloaded in our browser when we change some code. Next, let's look at the file structure and the files. In the folder static, you should put all your image files and CSS files. The second folder called templates contains the index files. And outside of these folders, we have our main app, app.py. Now I'm pasting in some code for the database connection. And then I'm going to walk you through all the code of the app.py file. In line 6, we are defining the URI for the database. When you use PostgreSQL, you first need to write PostgreSQL colon backslash backslash. Next, you need to fill in your username, then colon, and fill in your password, And then you need to write at localhost if you use localhost for the database, and then backslash the name of the database, which in our case is students. In line 8, we are creating an SQL Alchemy object, which we will use to connect to our database. And in the following section, we are creating a class for the students, and the class student extends the class db.model. We will be using this class to create the table inside of the database and also to create the student objects. Line 11 defines the table name, and in line 12 we define all the different columns for the table, which are the ID, first name, last name and pet. We define a column with db.column, and then in brackets you write the data type you want, and in our case the ID shall also be the primary key. So we set it to true. The ID will be automatically created by the database. In the lines 13 to 15, we define the columns for the other variables, and also we define that the maximum number of characters shall be 40. In line 70 to 20, you find the constructor for the objects, where you fill in first name, last name and pet, and self represents the instance of the object. In the section starting at line 27, we define the route for backslash submit. Also, we define the request methods possible for that route, which will be get and post. Inside of the submit function, we first check if the request method is post. And if this is the case, from our form input, we will fetch the first name, last name and pet. Now I will jump to the index.html file to show you how the app.py file and the index.html file are connected. In this file, we have a form action tag, which contains all our form inputs. Inside of this form tag, we define that the action will be the backslash submit and the method will be post. Also, we define names for our inputs, like here for example for the first name we define the fname, for the last name and so on. If we now go back to our app.py file, you can see here the equivalence to the HTML file, like we define submit, get and post, and here we filled in the names we have in the HTML file. In line 35, we are creating a student object from our form input, and in the next step we open up a session to our database and add the student to this session, and in the next line we are actually committing this student object to our database. I already started up Postgres and PGAdmin, but as you can see inside of our databases we don't have a student's database yet, so let's create this first. Create database, and then write in the name students and click on save. Now we are creating a table inside of the database, post some data to it and fetch data from the database. For this, go to your terminal and type Python and then write from app import db. So we have our db variable we can make queries on, and in the next step to create the table according to what we have defined here, we need to write db.createAll. And when you now go back to your database and right click on it and click refresh, then click on schema and click on table, then you can see we have now a students table here, and to see actually the columns, click on columns and you can see we have our four columns, ID, fname, lastname, pet. To exit, type exit and brackets. Now we are able to fill out our form and send it to the database. So let's write Harry and Potter, and all is already right. And this question, we click on yes, but this question will not be integrated. Then click on send. And then it says your data has been sent successfully. So let's jump over to our database and see if Harry is in it. For this, click on the students table and then on right click and click on view edit data all rows. And here you can see we have an ID of 1 and we have all the columns we created and we have the data we posted to the database. Next, let's look how you can fetch data from the database. First, you need to define the method get inside of one of your form tags here again. I didn't do this, but you can try it out on your own. So I'm commenting it out and just execute it anyway. So to fetch a certain student, just write db.session.query and student, you have to define which model actually you are working with, which is a class student here, then .filter and set student.id to 1 if you want to get the student with the ID 1. In line 42, we cycle through the student results and print the first name of each result. So let's click on send again to trigger this. And then here in the console, you can see it printed Harry. And one last thing I want to show you before I continue with part 3 of the tutorial. Let's go back to this side. So you can see we look forward to seeing you in September, Harry. This Harry we actually fetched from our data, and I wanted to show you how you can do this. After we did all the database queries, we are calling the render template method with the success.html page, and then we send some data to this page with setting the data variable to first name. Now let's jump to the success.html file. And here you can see we look forward to seeing you in September. And then to add the data here, you write curly braces twice and then you can fill in data here. In this final section, we are solving the error connection refused. And I'm talking about this error. Connection refused is the server running on localhost and accepting TCP connections on port 5432. This error you might get when you are trying to set up PostgreSQL and pgAdmin 4. To solve this error, you might have to change a certain configuration file, which for Linux you can find here. var lib postgres data postgres.config. So I'm going to put this path in the description box. I'm opening it with Vim. All right, and then go to the section connections and authentication. And here are two lines that might be commented out. Listen addresses, you need to uncomment this line and set it to localhost. In addition, you need to uncomment this line port equals 5432. Then you need to save and exit this file. In my case, I only exited because I didn't change anything. And then you need to restart PostgreSQL. In case you have any other issues with Arch-based Linux distros like Arch Linux or Manjaro, I will put the link with the Postgres article of the Arch Wiki in the description box. Thank you so much for watching and have a nice day. Bye!